Welcome to the Advancing Innovation in the Food Processing Industry workshop. We're really happy to have you here. Thank you for taking time of your busy schedules to be here. It's a great facility. You'll be introduced to it in a few minutes. But we're really happy to have such a good turnout. We've been sold out for almost 2 weeks now. So that's a great great response, and we're really happy to have you here. I do want to acknowledge, first of all, the presence of our Dutch speakers. I need to point out that they are here basically on a very goodwill mission. They're not being paid, they're on their own time. Half of them arrived last night. One of them will be here for the day, but won't be in Canada for even 48 hours. So it's quite a trip that he's made. There's somebody else who just had an injury and still made it. You'll see him. It's very obvious. So I do want to thank them for being here and being so open to share with us all the information that they will share and their own experiences in doing business in Food Valley. I know from the list of attendees that a lot of you don't know what the IFPT is, or we haven't had any direct contact with you. So I'm just going to give you a brief summary of what we are. The Institute of Food Processing Technology had its official opening 2 weeks ago, even though we started our training programs last year. And 2 weeks ago, it was announced that it is now named the Craig Richardson Institute of Food Processing Technology to recognize the effort and the work that Craig Richardson has put into creating this training institution. We are a new school at Conestoga College. We're part of the School of Engineering and Information Technology. We're located in Cambridge. And our mission is to deliver training and develop the skilled workforce for the food processing industry in Ontario, although we think we're going to be, our scope is going to grow beyond the Ontario borders in a few years. We are the only dedicated institution to achieve this mission in Canada, and we are very proud of our facilities and of our programs. That's all I am going to say about IFPT, because this is not about IFPT. I do want to introduce some of our staff in case you have any questions during the day or you'd like to have more information. There is information in your packages on the table about our programs and about what we do, but I do want to introduce our staff so that you can come to them and ask questions during the day if you like. So I'm going to ask them to stand up. Mihela Simeon, she is our program manager. She's responsible for the development of curriculum that meets the training needs of the industry. Barry Bremner, he is our technologist, and he's responsible for the pilot plant processing facility and for providing training as well. Susan McLaughlin, she is our communications officer. She is responsible for recruitment and going around the province and beyond the province lately to increase awareness of our programs. And Holly Ellis, she is outside at the registration desk. She's our admin assistant, and she is really the one that keeps us all together and on time and in line. So I would like now like to invite Ainsley Moore. She is the Facilities and Quality Assurance Manager for the Think Food Center. And before I give you the mic, thank you very much for having us here. It is really good of Maple Leaf to be sharing this facility with us.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. Thank you, Luis. Yeah, I just want to extend a welcome to all of you as well. Thank you so much for bringing the workshop here to Think Food. Maple Leaf built the Think Food Center in 2000, and we opened in 2009 as the home for our company's innovative processes. Before we built the center, we had our different business units because we make bread, meat, and pasta. We had each of those teams working independently, some of those teams even working at different sites. And we built this center so that they could all work here collaboratively and foster innovation collaboratively together. So the center houses kind of the whole innovative process for us. all the way from idea generation in our food-focused library to innovation itself in our benchtop spaces and our pilot scale spaces for meat and bakery, to presentation spaces like the one that you're in today, where we can host events like this and trade shows, as well as some smaller customer-based kitchens where we can show new products to the folks that we want to list them or sell for us. So it's a really great center focused on innovation. So when we heard that this workshop was taking place, we couldn't help but extend the invitation to have it done here. So thank you all very much for coming. I'm also going to take some time just to give you some administrative information. If you haven't found them already, the washrooms are just on the other side of the colored glass in Marketplace. So hang a right as you exit and a sharp left, and they're on your right, men's and women's both. We've also got designated smoking areas. So if you do need to have a cigarette at break, there's a butt stop just in this corner here behind the window if you'd like everyone to watch. If you want something a little more private, just again down at the other end of the building. So as you exit through the main doors, go past the herb planters, the pots, and you'll see probably a group of folks hanging out there. You can join them. And then also if there is an emergency, which we really hope there won't be, there's an emergency exit at the back of the room here, and as well the primary entrance that you came through is one of the closest exit also. So please enjoy your day. I'll be joining you as well for the day, so I look forward to speaking with each of you if you have any questions about the center. Thank you, Luis.
Thank you, Ainsley. So, I was also asked to let you know that there you can communicate with us via Twitter using the hashtag innovation workshop if you like during the day. And we will have Susan monitoring that communication if you're interested. Let's get going with the project. We have a really full day today, and the initial part of the day is presenting some highlights of a project that we're conducting for the Ontario Minister of Agriculture, Food and Rural Affairs. The main goal of this project was to identify opportunities to encourage the food and beverage processing industry to become more innovative. We all know how big and important this industry is, not just in Ontario, but across Canada. And we know it is competitive, and yet we are looking for ways to make it stronger and make it even more competitive in the global marketplace. Why the need for the project? As I said, we want to make it stronger, but there are some, there are different studies, different pieces of work that have been published in the last couple of years that show that there is a need for strengthening the innovation and productivity side of the industry, and not just the food processing industry, but for example, the Conference Board of Canada gave the industry a mark of a D in terms of innovation, and this is only last year. And we're not going to go into the details. There's no time really. There's another study that was just released last week by Deloitte. It's a really comprehensive study across the industry in Canada, benchmarking against the U.S. And one of their comments at the end of the study is that Canada is in urgent need of a new strategy, so to make it more competitive in the global market. And then as a result of a food and innovation forum that was held here 2 years ago, there's also again the highlight for a need for a strategy and the need to strengthen innovation and productivity across the industry. So there are several studies that point to the need to work on this area. Now, the first thing we're going to talk about, and I have asked our Dutch colleagues to explain it better in the next part of the day, is what does innovation mean? And it is, I think, unfortunate that it's become a buzzword and everybody uses it on a daily basis and everybody has a different meaning for it. And I just pulled together a list of events around innovation that are taking place or have taken place between the end of May and tomorrow. There are 7 events, plus this one. So, and if you look at the title of the first one that I mentioned, innovation meets commercialization. That seems like innovation is a different thing from commercialization. That's one definition of innovation that doesn't include commercialization. So there's lots of different meanings. It's not helping the industry. It's not helping anybody that we don't have a clear understanding. We don't agree on what it means. So we'll elaborate on this a little later. What is innovation? And then how did we do this project? We have three main areas. One is we developed a preliminary directory of service providers to the food processing industry in the area of innovation. It is part of your packages. It is not exhaustive. And the reason for this is that there isn't a simple way to find those out there that are providing services to the food processing industry in the area of innovation. So this doesn't include food safety training, food safety auditing. It doesn't include that. It doesn't include the actual design of a building. It does include anything that has to do with the process of innovation. Process design, building design may be a part of it, but we weren't focused on that. We wanted to see those providers that speak about innovation and how they can contribute to the process for the food processing industry. We also, as part of the project, decided we should have this event today. We didn't want to have just one written document that would be circulated to the industry and that probably wouldn't have much of an impact on industry. We thought that having this event and having the opportunity to interact with other industry members and hearing from people who live innovation on a daily basis would be a much better trigger for a reaction from industry and from the different organizations represented here. And then the third big component was benchmarking our Ontario industry with Food Valley. And we did this through a survey that was conducted both here in Ontario and in the Netherlands in Food Valley. And we also did a lot of online research to back up our research. Why did we choose Food Valley? Well, I'm just putting up two quotations from different websites. Food Valley is cited that that's a place where innovation ideas grow, and it talks about a fertile environment for innovation. Basically, Food Valley is a world-renowned food cluster in several areas, but mostly because of their innovative skills and environment. So we thought that it would be good to benchmark our industry against a cluster that is very well known for their innovative capacity. The survey was developed by Mihela Simeon and Ioana Dobrescu. They will be presenting the results in a few minutes. And it was basically an electronic questionnaire that was sent out to food processors and service providers and then followed up with a face-to-face interview in most of the cases. The follow-up was done over the phone, but in most cases it was done face-to-face. We did have two groups of target audiences. One was the food processors, and we even divided them into small, medium, and large. And then we had the service providers. The survey had questions that covered three main areas. One was around the term innovation. What does it mean? How do you approach it? What are your practices towards innovation in your organization? The second one talked about resources. Do you dedicate any resources to innovation? What are the resources that you require to conduct your innovation? And then the third area of the survey covered the topic of collaboration between companies, between organizations, and that is a topic that we're going to be elaborating on quite a bit more in the next 40 minutes or so. So the format for the day is that, as I said before, we thought that promoting or encouraging interaction between the attendees would be a much better way of trying to trigger a reaction from industry and getting at least a handful of our organizations walking out of here today with a good feeling about what they're going to do in their organizations on innovation. So please feel free to ask questions at any time and interact with each other. That's going to make the day a lot richer in terms of what we all learn. So I am now going to turn it over to Mihaela Simeon, who is going to present the results of the Ontario survey. Before she starts her presentation, I'd like to give you a couple of minutes to introduce yourselves within your own tables. If you haven't done so, please do that. I'll give you a couple of minutes and then I'll ask Mihaela to start her presentation on the Ontario results.